Pecha Kucha 90 Optimus Prime Time. Yeah, so I said it was going to be Transformers week last week, and I kind of got stuck on the main man. Transformers, I've always, you know, been a fan of the franchise, and I enjoy drawing them, but as you'll quickly see, it's not like I'm good at it or anything. But before we get into that, I did another blog post. I just talked about me on Instagram and how I loved it so much, I went and created a Tumblr 2 hours later so I didn't have to use it anymore. It's awkward showing my blog because obviously I can only show what I can show on the screen and I don't really want to post the whole thing. It's not like you're going to read it in 20 seconds. So the cats and dogs thing I was working on with Melissa Hill, you know, I did full body animal portrait things, as you can see, for Melissa to use in the kind of the framework that she's like mocked up. And, you know, this is the kind of idea. So it's, you know, repeating images with different, you know, comments, which are jokes and stuff like that. And then the occasional woof to break things up. I kind of feel like, yeah, you know, I love how it's looking. This is a great way for it to end. And I kind of feel like I'm done with this. It's up to her to do the rest. I watched a 30-minute breakdown of Control-Alt-Delete, the gaming webcomic by this guy who went on it hard. He criticized it like it was real art or something. There's more than I can really talk about him talking about, but it's this idea of he's psychoanalyzing this thing, and now I'm psychoanalyzing his psychoanalysis, and the whole thing just seems a bit torrid. And Control-Alt-Delete isn't worth this amount of attention in the first place. It's just not that good. Whether you laugh at the jokes or not, but, you know, whatever, it's Transformers week, it's prime time! So, the box office artist always has my back when it comes to Transformers. You know, the first thing I did was Google how to draw Optimus Prime, saw what tutorials came up. Obviously, the box office artist was like one of the few ones that came up on Google that wasn't for 10-year-olds. Because he's, you know, he's a professional artist. And he draws Optimus Prime without using straight lines. He was using a French curve there. And, you know, this is another one of his things. Typically, he does pen and ink work on paper and then, like, takes it into Photoshop to colour. He does commissions, and you know what? He's not so expensive. I could entertain, you know, buying one if it wasn't for postage and that kind of stuff. So yeah, kind of what sums up the week is a lot of terrible attempts to draw Generation 1 Optimus Prime from the 80s cartoon, and just not getting the proportions right. It's just something that's kind of how I draw now. I just don't put things where they're supposed to be. So I kind of walked away from the box office artist and then went to look at some other tutorials on YouTube and ended up seeing a video he'd uploaded for his friend Jazza. I think his channel's called Draw with Jazza. He's pretty popular. So there's no escaping James Reyes. He does like to overwork his stuff. And it turns out I like details in art, even though I'm not sure I want to replicate. So, you know, this is probably my first prime of the week where I tried to take what I knew and just draw it without direct reference. Just dump Megatron in the back because that's how it is. You know, the second pencils are tighter. I should really do a third pencils, and then maybe they'd be good. On the left, another reference picture. Very rare to see Optimus Prime's neck, so on the right I try to, you know, draw his neck into this one and then kind of change the way his legs work so he's got musculature under armor plate because I'm trying to hope if I internalize the process I can externalize it and make better art. So here's a guy I came across called Peter Draws who does really cool like pen and ink work. He's like a proper artist or something, and he just kind of reminded me that it doesn't always have to be so, you know, blasé as the stuff I do or basic. Something James Reyes, the box office artist, was talking about was like, you know, you do silhouettes to try and figure out what you're doing. You don't worry about detail. You just try and get a feel for things. So, you know, Transformers have proportions that are almost human, but not quite. And I still don't quite have my stuff together when it comes to that. Action scenes. I've had this action scene of Optimus Prime versus Megatron I've been trying to put together for a while. But what it is instead of a single image, I keep imagining it as a sequence. So whenever I start drawing it, I'm changing it as I draw it. I should just draw a comic. I just, for, you know, looking at all this like ink work, I just decided I was going to ink this in. So I just made the G pen super big, went in super rough, and kind of, yeah, backlit Optimus Prime. I'm not sure that made sense, but you know, nothing I do typically makes sense. I was experimenting with Indian ink brush that gives really rough edges. I was listening to Metal Gear Solid music, so I came up with a little montage thing. You know, this is not what I was going to do, but it's what I did because this is what happens when I listen to Metal Gear Solid music. And then I thought, you know, let's try and do something with the airbrush and clean it up. No reference used. It's not the worst, it's not the best, but I had a good time. This is ironically where I feel like my work's probably going to get the tightest when I use things like the airbrush and I step away from like black ink work. Steam Tams, it found me after so very long, the Quentin Tarantino edition that's got, you know, just like a Tarantino movie, it's got all these other stories in the middle of it that all come together in the end, although not really. And Seymour here has shot a couple of dudes stone cold dead, their heads exploded. Don't ask me when this happened, I don't know. So yeah, is it going to be Metal Gear Week next week? Because the exact same thing that happened last week happened this week, where right at the end of the week I drew something else that I had a lot of fun doing. I don't know. Metal Gear Solid is something I typically draw every once in a while. Never with any great degree of commitment or skill, of course. Maybe I give it a week. I learn to draw Metal Gear Rex. I do some Ocelot stuff. I don't know. Maybe not. Transformers week. Well, since this was only prime time, maybe it's going to be Megatron Monday tomorrow. Who knows, right? But yeah, really, the smiley show is what I need to sort out. But I, in my brain, I've turned it to work, so now I'm ducking it like I do when I have a job. That's going to need some unpackaging. Of course, what I will do on Monday is my next blog post because, you know, really, everything I'm trying to do is to just build habits. And then at some point, once those habits are secure, then I start worrying about building skill like aggressively. Like 15-hour days, like just drawing hands until I'm like Jim Lee good at drawing hands. But yeah, that won't be this week. It won't be hands week. I think we had one of those and it didn't really go anywhere. But that brings us to the end of Pecha Kucha 90, and I will see you next time.